Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Dr. Sam's Biology. In this video, we will discuss about recessive epistasis. We know that epistasis is a phenomenon in which one gene that is present on different loci suppresses another gene. And when this is done by any recessive gene, then it is called a recessive epistasis. Epistasis caused by recessive gene is called recessive epistasis. When a recessive gene suppresses another gene, another dominant gene that is present on different loci, then it is called recessive epistasis. For example, here we have a gene, this small x, small a. These are two alleles of a gene and these are present on a chromosome. And we have another gene that is present on different chromosome, capital B, capital B. So this is dominant gene, this is recessive gene. When this recessive gene suppresses this dominant gene, then this phenomenon is called recessive epistasis. Example of recessive epistasis is coat color in a mice. When we cross a black mice with albino mice, so black is capital C, capital C, small a, small a, small c, capital A, capital A, then we will get agouti color. When we cross or we mate this agouti mice with another agouti, suppose this is male and this is female, then we will get four type of gamete: capital C, capital A, capital C, small c, capital A, and small c, small a. Similarly there. So here we will get agouti, 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 because both the genes capital C and capital A are there in these four. We will get agouti also. Here this is black. So this C, capital C, is causing black color. This is agouti, both are there. This is also black. This is agouti, both capital C and capital A are there. This is also agouti. These are albino. This one, and this one, and this one. Here, in this case, you can see that when both capital C and capital A are present, then color is agouti. When capital C alone is there and capital A is absent, instead of capital A there is small a, recessive gene, then color is black. But in this case, you can see that small c is there, but here dominant gene is present. Here also dominant gene is present. Here also dominant gene is present. In all these three cases, this one, and this one, dominant A gene is present, but it can't express itself. Why it can't express? Because another gene, another recessive gene is there, that is called small c. This gene is expressing this dominant gene. So this is called recessive epistasis. Here, in that case, this gene, small c, this gene is expressing this dominant gene. In this case, also in this case also, and in this, in all these three cases, it is expressing. So what is molecular basis of? Before molecular basis, you can see that out of 16, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 are agouti and black. 1, 2, 3 are black and 4 are albino. This one, this one, this one, and this one. So ratio is 9 is to 3 is to 4. So this is the ratio of recessive epistasis. Now coming to the molecular basis of recessive epistasis. So first we have precursor molecule. This molecule in first case is colorless. When capital C gene is there, capital C, it will convert this precursor, colorful precursor, into black pigment. And when gene A, capital A is there, capital A is there, it will convert this pigment into agouti color. So when both these genes, capital C and capital A, are there, the color will be agouti. In second case, similarly, this is precursor molecule, colorless molecule. When capital C gene is there, it will convert it into black. But when capital A is absent, smaller is there, it can't convert black into agouti. So color will be black. So in that case, when capital C is there and small a is present, then color will be black. In third condition, similarly, precursor molecule is colorless and capital C gene is absent. Here, instead of capital C, small c is there. So this is non-functional gene. So there will be no pigment. So from colorless pigment, there will be no pigment. So reaction will stop there. Now you can see that the genotype might be capital A, capital A, capital A, small a, small a. It doesn't matter. If this gene is absent, capital C gene is absent, this gene can't express itself because this gene can convert black into agouti. If there is no black color, then there will be no agouti. So it can't express in absence of capital C gene. So here this gene, small c gene, is pressing its expression or its function. This is called a recessive epistasis. So in that case, you can see that this gene, this small c gene, this is dominant to capital A gene. This small c is dominant to small c gene is dominant to capital A gene. So this is called recessive epistasis. So this is epistatic gene, small c, and this capital A is hypostatic gene. So this is recessive epistasis.